Hello everybody, this is Autech from the Minions Have Spawned podcast. Today I am going to be showing you guys how to play Nunu, how to jungle with him and the best route to take, and I'm just going to show you the first 10 minutes of a game here. First thing you want to do is you're going to start off with boots, as well as a vision ward and a health potion. The reason for this is you're going to try to get that ward down at their red buff so that you can possibly gank their jungler. While we're waiting for the minions to spawn here, I'm going to go ahead and show you my rune pages for Nunu. I have 3 armor pin reds here, as well as 2 armor pin quints. What that does is that gives me the 12 armor pin I need for the jungle mobs, because the jungle mobs have around 12 armor. In my yellows here I have armor, and in my blues I have magic resist. That lets you tank late game, because late game you don't do much damage as Nunu, even if you do go AP with him. My other reds I have attack speed, and might sound kind of like a weird choice, but attack speed helps his passive to proc quicker, because every 7th auto attack you're going to get a free cast, which is great, and it can really save you in team fights, so, like if you didn't have enough mana to use your ult, for example. Right here we're just making sure I don't get ganked at my buff. As you can see, they clairvoyanced it, so I'm kind of staying in the bushes here so that they don't see me with the clairvoyance. So what I do here is I start at the big wolf. I go ahead and eat him, and you'll see why here in a minute. I'm gonna have Lux leash the golem for me. So yeah, eat the big wolf, run up here. Your first point is gonna be in consume. So yeah, I'm just waiting until minute 55 to get wait for blue to spawn here. And I actually auto-attacked him before Lux leashed him, but it's alright. You're gonna wait until he has around 500 health, and you can go ahead and smite him. You're gonna put your second point in Blood Boil. I run around here for a minute waiting for my consume to come up. Okay, now I'm gonna go ahead and head over to his jungle. Their jungler is Trundle, which usually does start at blue buff. So that's what I'm counting on here, is the fact that he started at blue buff. Run over here, his wrath's still here, eat his big wrath. You know, that takes gold from him, gives it to me. Gonna go ahead and drop a ward here at his red. And still no Trundle, so I'm gonna try to go for his small golems here. And I have that ward there, so if he does come running up here, I will be able to get away. So I get one, going for the next small golem here. Here he comes. And I do have more health than him, but right now all I have is Blood Boil, so I probably would not win in a team fight. And also, I am in his jungle, so that Zealand could also gank me. Wasn't really going for a gank here, but this Irelia was kind of complaining that Zealand was giving her a hard time, so I figured I'd just run in there real quick. Okay, now I'm coming back down here to my small wolves. Finish them off. The reason I ate that big wolf earlier is because if I would have gotten both of his small golems, I would have been level 3, which would have let me have Ice Blast up. And if I would have had Ice Blast up, I probably would have got the kill on him, but I wasn't able to get that second golem. Alright, so just doing some jungling here. You always want to use your consume on the big wrath, because it's going to shot it. You're going to keep Blood Boil up the whole time. Here's Trundle, it is red. It's probably too late for me to get a gank on him, though. I started running up here. I wasn't really looking at the health that the lizard had, but yeah, he already got it. So, back to my jungling. Bottom lane's pushing all the way to the enemy's turret, so I'm not going to be able to gank them, and top's a little overextended, so I might be able to get a gank on him. But this Vlad here is really low, so I'm going to go ahead and try to get a gank on him. I am only level 3, but that shouldn't stop me from trying to gank if someone's overextended like this. Okay, here's my opening. The reason I flashed in there is because I wanted to get that ice blast off on him before he pooled, which I did. Which slowed him and allowed us to get the kill there. Took a couple turret hits for Lux. Consumed one of her mobs. I never stick around in a lane after a gank. You don't want to gimp your you don't want to gimp your carry's XP, so you just want to get in and out after a gank. Bottom lane getting kind of owned here. She got ganked by Trundle. Really nothing I can do here. Just kind of seeing where he's going. To go ahead and be here, but then I look down and Sion getting ganked again. So yeah, now I'm just gonna kind of watch the lane from bottom. A lot of what you're gonna be doing is jungling is, yeah, you're gonna gank, yeah, you're gonna jungle, but you also have to make sure you're watching the lanes for people because you don't want to get your turrets pushed. There's another clairvoyance there. Gonna go ahead and be the first thing you get is jungle Nunu. It's kind of different than other junglers, or at least the way I play him is you're gonna get your boots of lucidity, grab a ward, some health pots, and this is actually gonna keep you out in the jungle and out ganking for basically as long as you want. Having that speed is your biggest asset early game as Nunu. It's kind of the whole point in playing him, is being able to get. You got the blood boil for the speed, and then you also have your level 2 boots really early on. So that's going to help you be kind of all over the place, guarding lanes, ganking, etc. So just grabbing red buff here. I would have got this earlier if I wouldn't have had to go bottom and watch it, but you know, you can't take the same jungle route every game. You're going to have to adapt. Yeah, just do what feels right for that game. I think a lot of junglers get in the mindset that they have to take the same route every game, but you're going to have to change depending on what's going on. And it seems Trundle counter jungled some of my wraths there. I'm waiting for this Sion to get a stun off on one of them so I can come out. And I don't have flash up or anything, so it's kind of hard for me to gank unless they get a stun off. So yeah, I'm just waiting. Probably wasted my time. I thought they were gonna come after him here too. Nope. So gotta cut your losses. Keep on jungling. Now I just happened to come. I saw their blue buff was coming up, so I came up here to check on it. And I actually stole it here. And got away. This is another good thing about playing Nunu the way you are early game is you're gonna be able to get away from anyone. So here's a little team fight. Not sure what they were thinking, initiating here. We get the kill on Trundle. Then Namumu runs in with no health. And he's dead. Yeah, not too bright on their part. So we're just going to push this turret a little bit. Another good thing about Nunu is your ability to push turrets is pretty good, especially if you are pushing with another melee, because you can blood boil them and greatly increase the damage you're going to be putting out on the turret. So yeah, that's about it. That's the first 10 minutes of a pretty standard game, I would say, for Nunu. Your priorities are just going to be getting around the map, getting your ganks off, keeping your jungle down, and depending on how the game's going, you can counter jungle more or less, and also depending on who their jungler is and how comfortable you feel being in their jungle. Nunu is, he's a really good jungler. He has a quick jungle. He's not the best late game, but if you can get off to a strong start early game, you're going to help your team push the win towards the end. The next video, I'm going to be highlighting some ganks and some later game stuff, some ult placement, and yeah. Thanks for watching. This has been the Minions Have Spawned YouTube channel, Nunu Video 1. and I am Autech.